pieces of carpet on the way, so he picks them up and moves them out of the way so he can, like, you know, like, spread out a blanket or whatever he's doing in the studio at the time, you know? And then, like, he's spreading out the blanket and seeing whether that kind of somehow transforms something, and it doesn't work, you know, and he kind of puts it aside. And, you know, the next day or the next hour or 2 weeks later, he'll, like, be over here and he'll kind of find those two carpets like that. And, like, it's kind of by not trying to do it that he can do it. It's by not trying to solve a problem. As long as you don't try to solve it and kind of look at next to the problem, that maybe. So he always jokes about, like, him as an artist. What he does, he just shows up to the studio and, like, he needs to wait for something, for things to happen. You know, that's what he needs to do. He's like, yeah, I come and I, like, move things, you know, and I just spend time living with these things. I share my life with these materials. And I, like, touch, you know, move them around. And it's by doing that that then sometimes I kind of find my work. I find the sculpture there. And you turn the stuff that he was kind of leaning against the wall because he was in the way while you were looking for a crate. And that's how we did that elephant ass thing. Like, it was a few weeks ago, we were, like, looking for the kissing carpets in his storage somewhere, and he's like, oh, wait, okay, yeah, here, wait, hold this. And then, like, you lean all these things, and then we kind of, like, open the door and close it, and right when we close the door, we, like, had that particular angle on that crate with that blanket on it, and then he was like, oh my god, that's, like, what's that shape here, what's that, you know, and you know, it's kind of, but he would never have found it without this kind of act of living with these things, and, like, experiencing life. That's kind of what I mean by life, you know, like, it's about living.